Hello and welcome to Meet the Boss TV. In this programme, how Pandora, the Danish jewellery company adorning itself across Europe and North America, is taking IT transformation to the next level. Deloitte says IT functions that embrace and develop their people will increase the likelihood of change and ultimately find new ways to support in the drive to create new revenue streams. But to do so, IT has to first transform to become a true business partner, something that Pandora is all too familiar with. I asked Henrik Hoffmeyer, VP for Group IT at Pandora, to talk us through their transformation, starting with where he thinks the role of the CIO is heading.
People argue that the new role is a chief digital officer and other names, but it has undeniably changed, just as I would say the role of the CMO has changed. I would say that the question is rather, what new role in the company is the former CIO best suited to fill? And I would argue that CIOs have a strategic importance now more than ever because of their ability to guide and consult the organization in terms of how technology will impact them, how they can make use of technology to have a better performance on their business. And of course, ensure that systems and processes support the business.
Connecting the dots between technology trends and business value is obviously critical for today's IT decision makers. How are you using technology to solve these real business issues over at Pandora?
Once you decide in an IT organization not just to be reactive, but you want to be more proactive towards the business, then you have more or less two options. You can either be very, hunt for the innovation, look to new technologies and see how they can quickly provide value for the business, or you can harvest the existing investments you have already done in IT, and see how you can utilize some of those to drive additional business value. So what we did was we established the role of a business technology manager, which prime responsibility is to meet the business and to know everything about technology, but do it in an expert position. Usually someone from an industry position. So within marketing, we have a business technology manager who has experience from marketing. Within finance, we have a consultant that have worked for many years within technology support of finance processes. So really bringing IT next to the business and around the table and ultimately into the organization. Using our business intelligence competence center and our whole cooperation with finance has enabled us to bring, data sources from our worldwide network of stores through our data warehouse, and through a simple presentation layer, we have been able to provide for a lot of insightful information for the designers to design better products, to look at how materials are used and sold globally, to make better forecasting and planning system, as well as a simple inventory or campaign adjustment decision. And this, retail insight, as we call it, this tool has delivered critical information required to transform Pandora to a more retail-focused wholesaler. And this, I believe, is some of the breakthrough initiatives that we have done. And what we found was that there's much insight to gain using your existing information about customers and business partners to leverage that information to provide it for the business so they can make better decisions, design better products, to adjust campaigns. All this information that you already have is actually much easier to realize high business value than looking to, new exotic new technology trends. So I would say it's always a matter about striking a balance, and for the CIO today, it's really important to strike the right balance.
In today's landscape, striking the right balance means reducing the gap between IT and the business. No easy task considering the hunger for cloud, mobility, and new data. So how do you go about finding that balance?
In Pandora, we have already adopted a cloud-first strategy, meaning that anything that we adopt, we have to consider using the cloud first. And we already in 2009 started our first deployment using cloud technology. So in that sense, we have been quite early on adopting cloud. And I think that's one of the most important decisions we made when I look back, because that's the only way that we have been able to support an amazing business growth. If we were to provide for that growth in our data center, growing close to 5,000% in just 12 months, that would have been extremely difficult running your own operation, your own server park. So adopting cloud has been key to us. It also is important when you roll out to a lot of markets. We have in very rapid gone from about 12 or let's say a dozen markets to today 73 markets worldwide. And once you expand your business, it's very important that you can expand it quickly and be flexible and scalable about it. In addition, retail usually have some sort of seasonality that you need to let's say support. You have the Christmas sales. Now, if you don't have performance during Christmas, you risk a lot on the business. The issue is more what risk appetite does the business have, and assessing and agreeing on that risk appetite with the rest of the business can be very difficult. So sometimes it ends up with just being black and white and saying, well, then we cannot allow for anything. I think that IT has a key role in working together with the security department on assessing that risk appetite and then building a platform that supports your employees the best way so they have the flexibility.
Of course, building that platform relies on understanding how the business and its market are changing. Managing that change is key. So how do you go from surviving to thriving in this new age of data and technology?
You need to take ownership let's say, of the important things that drive change. That would be, for instance, in our case, we need to take ownership of data. We need to have the right systems to support real-time, let's say, preemptive forecasting of change in demand. We need to insource the critical part of our organization so we are not suddenly, because there is a change, extremely dependent on external parties who might not have the same priorities as we do. So establish, let's say, a response capability to change. And then we need to retain strategic knowledge internally. So once change happens, you also put in control of that change. Secondly, I would say that in order to, adapt very quickly to change, you need to bring down complexity. And that is so important today. But in the future, it's not going to be about the cost. It's going to be the time it takes to change and to adapt to change. So in that sense, the new age, it will be extremely important to bring down complexity so you're constantly able to change your processes and change your IT. In principle, decrease the impact a certain change in the market has on your business. Thirdly, I would say you need to establish things on a flexible and scalable platform. So when you have changes also in terms of up and downturns in the industry, you're able to push down cost if that is needed, or to scale up if that is needed. And that is both from an IT and a process perspective. And I guess that's also why a lot of companies are now looking to complete process outsourcing, because you also need to be flexible on the processes.
Great, well, I'd like to pull another quote out from you if I could, Hans. You said that the next big battle will be in managing social networking, which only happens when CMO and CIOs of the world work together creating new experiences for the consumer. Is this a next step on Pandora's journey? Is there anything you can outline that you're thinking on this tricky but ultimately rewarding next step?
I believe that just as the world as a CIO is changing, so is the role of the CMO changing rapidly. So you need to, from an IT perspective, also provide for what capabilities are able or available today for marketing departments in terms of, let's say, big data or similar initiatives that will actually drive completely new insights into your consumers. And that requires you, again, to take ownership of data. It doesn't matter if it's out there in the cloud. you need to know what data you have access to and be able to drive business value out of that data and present it to the business in an understandable format that they can then bring forward in their organization. Marketing might want know what it is they want. IT can support them. So the connectivity here is extremely tight, and especially for a company like Pandora that has a strong brand, we really need to understand our customers, and this goes very close together with a marketing organization. We sit on the data, they need to have the insight, we need to work together.
And in the transforming world of enterprise IT, understanding the needs of the business is the quickest way to avoid becoming a reactive department. Engaging and adding value to the business is pivotal. But what else can IT leaders do to ensure their role in a transforming rather than evolutionary world of IT?
There are several, changes that you need to make in order to be in a more transformational role. I would say that first and foremost comes that you need to have business knowledge. You need to understand the business better than IT. You need to have a focus on really understanding the business processes and the goals of the business. If not, you'll get told what to transform in your own organization, because you're going to end up in a very reactive position. New systems and requirements are pushed to you rather than driven by you. So my call to action would definitely be to establish this business technology manager or a similar role that can actually engage adding value to the business. I would also say complexity. I mean, keep bringing down complexity. You will end up have a lot of excess time now if you don't have so many complexity issues, and you can spend that time with the business. Then I would say, let's say transform. I mean, you need to establish a capable organization of actually holding the transformational role. It requires a different set of discipline from, say, operational excellence. You don't want to have so many creative thoughts in your data center, but you want to have your transformational part of your organization, what we call the demand organization, driving new demands together with the business. And that requires a different type of person. And finally, I would say that you shouldn't be afraid. You shouldn't be afraid of claiming your position as a transformational leader in IT. There's absolutely no reason why you should not be able and not be the right person to drive the business forward and really provide for shareholder value. You can do that from an IT perspective.